Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 16 September, on the front page you have voices grow louder against Shah's pitch for Hindi. So this is the comments which have come from the Home Minister Amit Shah. He has said that the most spoken language is Hindi and this could work to unite the country. So this has got sharp reaction from the opposition parties. And you can see here the statements being given. The southern states especially are opposed to this because their language there is not linked to Hindi. That is the Dravidian languages which are spoken. The Dravidian language family's languages spoken in southern states of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Maharashtra, Telangana, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. And Tamil Nadu has historically seen violent protests too and you know, stern resistance to any push for Hindi. Then here you have Saudis to tap oil reserves after attacks on plants. So Saudi Arabia will use its vast oil reserves to offset disruption to production, is what the prince here, Salman Abdulaziz bin Salman, has said. So there were drone attacks on two major oil facilities on 14 September. So this has knocked 5.7 million barrels per day production off. So that is close to 6% of global crude supplies. And this is NRC will be compiled in Haryana too. So the Chief Minister of Haryana, Manohar Lal Khattar, has said that National Register of Citizens will be compiled in Haryana. So the way we have seen the exercise conducted in Assam to detect illegal migrants, now it is said it will be conducted in Haryana as well by its Chief Minister. Then on page 6 you have windfall for Orisha tribals if single-use plastic is banned. So we know that single-use plastic should be banned and the Indian government may take such a decision on 2nd October. So if single-use plastic is banned, then alternatives will be sought for and biodegradable alternatives are required. And here in Orisha tribals, you can see 5 million are involved in plate making from leaves. So two major leaves of forest species, sal and sili, are used and these biodegradable plates, cups can be made. So they would get a good opportunity if single-use plastic is banned. And many tribal groups have formed federations as such too. So tribal women are involved in this activity and they formed federations too to get a better deal in trade. Then on page 8 you have KCR opposes uranium mining plan. So this is Telangana Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao, who has sought support from all parties in opposing project at Nallamala Forest. So this he is categorically opposed to this regarding granting permission for uranium mining in Nallamala Forest. So he's clearly saying that no such grant should be provided. It would adversely affect the forest region. He said that if central government tries to push through the project, the state was prepared to fight with the center against such a decision. On page 9, you have vulture culture. How the bird was saved from extinction. So number of vultures declined from 40 million in the 1980s to few thousands in 2009. But now we can see that vulture population, which had sharply declined, has been revived now. So you can see white-backed vulture was rescued from Kyoledo National Park in Rajasthan, where vultures were dying at an alarming rate. So many steps have been taken, like diclofenac has been banned, which would result in vultures dying when they fed on the carcass of dead cattle. So cattle were given diclofenac, drug, you can see. So that has been banned. It's a veterinary drug used for veterinary purposes too, but it was banned in 2008. So it was commonly administered to cattle to treat inflammation. So this has resulted in vulture population being revived. Then this is Survey of India to deploy 300 drones for mapping country. So high resolution maps will be made through this, which will facilitate digitization of land titles in villages. On the editorial page, the first editorial is waiting for reforms. So this is regarding the stimulus incentives which have been announced. So it is said the whole promise, but structural reforms are nowhere on the horizon. So economic reforms are being, announced, stimulus and incentives have been announced, but structural reforms have not been forthcoming. Then this is effort worth emulation. So this is regarding Rajasthan's Jan Suchna portal. So for bringing in transparency in governance under the RTI Act. So the editorial says that Rajasthan's Jan Suchna portal is a step in the right direction for transparency in governance. And it's an effort worth emulation, worth copying. Other states should also have such initiative taken. The lead article is why India's growth figures are off the mark. So this is regarding over-reliance on organized sector for official GDP data. It is said is causing gross miscalculation. But then even if there is only official organized sector data being taken into consideration, then still you can see that there is a decline. So the decline cannot be negated, cannot be refuted. Then this is a dilution that falls short of the law. So there are several loopholes in the process of the substitution of Article 370, which make the action problematic. So this article says that how, you know, the dilution which has taken place has some loopholes and challenges, because technically Article 370 has not been abrogated. Rather, Constitution Order Number 273 as such is declaration under Article 373 of the Constitution. So if our declaration is under Article 370, then how can 370 be abrogated? Just Article 370 has been substituted by a new paragraph. So this says that the new paragraph says that all provisions of the Constitution as amended from time to time without any modifications and exceptions have been made applicable to Jammu and Kashmir. That is that. So it brings out some technical details of the steps being taken. On the op-ed page, you have mission successful, end product defunct. So this is regarding train 18. It was completed in record time and it was launched with fanfare, but still train 18 project now finds itself off the track. So there had been controversies which had emerged regarding train 18, that it did not follow strictly the terms and conditions which are given for its manufacture. But then even without little tweaks which the manufacturers said, which the engineers involved said were required, so we see train 18 being now being impacted by the internal turf war. So train 18 has appears to have become latest victim of this age old malady of the Indian railways. So you can see. So it's the interdepartmental rivalries which have resulted in train 18 project being derailed. Then this is the litmus test for free speech. So this says the court should uphold constitutional rights by reaffirming the Brandenburg test. So freedom of speech as enshrined in Article 19 of the Constitution needs to be upheld. But then there are, you know, they are not absolute rights, but subject to reasonable restrictions, of course. So in America, US Supreme Court has laid down bad tendency test to determine whether the restriction was reasonable or not. So that is being spoken of here in Indian context too. So this was the Brandenburg test of USA. The term comes from there. So applying this Brandenburg test in Bhima Koregaon case, where freedom of speech is being, you know, abrogated, is spoken of in this article. On page 13, you have India-Australia to elevate strategic ties. So the two countries are likely to conclude a logistic support and maritime cooperation agreements during Defence Minister Rajnath Singh's visit to Australia in November. Then on international page, you have Iran rejects US charge that it was behind attacks on Saudi oil plants. So this is there on front page too. Iran says US bases, aircraft carriers in the region are within its missile range. So this it has said, but it rejects charges that it was behind the attack on Saudi oil plants. And this is Hong Kong protesters call on UK to protect them from China. So now Hong Kong protesters have called on their former colonial power, which was ruling them till 1990s. So it says that they should come forward and protect them from China. They want democracy in the region. So protests have turned violent. You can see police fired tear gas, water cannons to disperse the crowd. Then this is Israel approves new settlement in West Bank on the eve of polls. So Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has approved a new settlement in the occupied West Bank. So just 2 days ahead of the general election. And here you have uproar after Malala seeks UN help for Kashmiri girls. So Nobel Peace Prize winner and Pakistani activist Malala Yousafzai has urged the UN to work towards peace in Kashmir and help children in the valley get back to their schools. So she had turned into like came into limelight when she fought for her education rights when the Taliban in Pakistan was not allowing, the tribal regions of Pakistan was not allowing girls to get educated. So she fought for that. And she has been fighting for education, especially for girls. And now she has urged UN to help Kashmiri girls who are not in school. So the valley is shut and children can't go to schools. So she wants to, UN to help children in the valley get back to their schools. And there's no important news on the business page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.